We've all heard that crime doesn't pay, but even if it did, the people we're going to talk about tonight couldn't count the loot. Dumb criminals. Dumb ones, Tim. You paying attention?
No.
Good.
Robbing a
bank. He's getting in the spirit of things. Okay. Before we get started, we should once again introduce our panel of experts. We're not talking about sex, Tim. Don't look so disappointed.
Oh, then I'm going to be lost.
Sex.
Okay. First, on the left, we have the irrepressible, formerly unliftable, but now slim, trim, Tym Moss.
Hi.
That was like a wrestler intro.
Yes. Yes.
No holds barred on this show, I'll tell you that. So, Tim, you're a man of many talents. What do
yes.
you do?
What am I doing? I'm a singer, I'm an actor, I've got film and theater and
Good
television
job.
And music and all kinds of stuff going on.
He's full of activities.
Yes.
Okay. On my other, this is the right, right?
This is the right.
Yes.
The other direction.
The other right.
Lola Bastinado, who I think I crowned as a erotic media personality, whatever that means.
Yeah, what the hell does that mean? But I'll take it. It sounds good. Mm. It sounds good.
I like that
it
title.
Sounds like
that's
you.
A good title.
Now,
it sounds like me?
Yeah.
All right, we'll roll with that then.
Is it safe to say if we had a gang, Lola would handle the interrogations?
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That would totally be me. And,
we could make a lot of money off those videos,
yeah.
I can tell you that. Okay.
Yeah. I'll come in with a drinking tray. That'll be my job.
Yeah.
Cigarettes and stuff. I'll go
we have work for you. She's going to interrogate the women. You will try to get information out of the men using your
nice.
Feminine
yeah.
wiles.
Yes, I'll be all nice. They say that you actually get more information being nice than through torture.
Yeah. You get more, what is it, more flies with honey?
Yeah.
Than
bees.
Mm-hmm.
Or bees with,
mm-hmm.
yeah, something.
That's why they call
it honey. How many flies have you gotten down with honey?
I usually don't eat flies.
No, the metal would mess up your teeth. The metal would mess up your teeth, wouldn't it? Flies.
Oh, the flies.
The fly. Zipper.
Oh! She's not. Sinking insects.
Good, getting in the dumb criminal spirit of things. Very, very good.
I like biology. My head always goes to biology.
Yeah.
Not
biology.
Speaking of which, we have retired New York escort.
Yes.
Now, this is a good show for you because you have skirted the law on occasion,
oh, yeah.
Wait, often wearing a skirt.
Yes,
yeah.
And high boots. And garter belt.
Okay, so we are going
my
to run some, look at this, is getting its ratings. Do you feel better
talking.
About yourself?
I feel myself as you guys keep talking.
I do that too, don't
watch.
Worry.
Oh, like, this is how you tell who is gay and who isn't. The one who's gay keeps talking. Oh, okay.
All right.
For our first,
okay.
For a, can we hear her?
Yeah.
Can we hear all
okay.
the parts of her?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Do they make any sound when you bounce up and down?
No, they're too small.
Okay, that's unfortunate. Well, is there any.
You like squeaky tits?
Is there a price range based on size?
On what? Size of tits?
Yes.
It could be, but it has to, a lot of times it has to match the face. But it depends. Like, if his fetish is tits, then yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But if it's, you know, an escort, he usually wants a combo. And, you know, it depends on what he wants more so. It depends on the
price.
It's
kind of like a buffet, basically.
You know, yeah.
Good.
So there's like a menu.
I knew
well, yeah,
show
everyone's
you all
different,
about
they all
sex, no matter what
different.
I call it.
Yeah.
You notice I'm being very quiet.
Yeah.
You know, some people,
so
you know,
far.
There's more
so
priorities
far.
Given to different things. You know, some guys want bigger tits and they don't care about the face. Other ones want a beautiful face and they don't care about the tits. Other ones
mm-hmm.
want legs. Other ones want
I definitely
a nurse,
want a woman with legs. I
a nurse
want that
or a schoolgirl, you know?
Okay.
I like limbs.
Down to business. Important business. For our first dumb criminal, we're staying close to home.
Okay.
New
oh, there's
Jersey.
Plenty.
New Jersey.
New Jersey.
Sopranos territory.
I think they breed them.
Okay. Now, this is a guy who had what seems to me to be a good plan. You guys let me know what you think. Mm-hmm. He wants to rob a convenience store. So what he plans to do is go in, pull out a 20, ask the guy behind the register to open the drawer to give him change.
Mm-hmm.
Then he's going to pull out his piece, take all the money from the register and leave.
Okay.
Seems like
sounds
a reasonable
solid.
Plan, right?
Sounds yeah. Step one, work. Step yeah. two, step three.
A regular
okay.
robbery.
Yeah.
Now he does it, and it goes off pretty much as planned.
Mm-hmm.
Pulls out the 20, guy opens the register, takes the piece, takes all the money out of the register and leaves. Only two problems. Number one, he forgets to take his 20 back when he leaves. Number two, there's only $15 in the register.
Oh, my
This guy robs a store and loses
$5. I wonder if he can still be prosecuted, right?
Because for losing money.
For being a freaking idiot.
Yeah.
Like, why would you?
If you lost money, was it a robbery?
No, that's a very deep philosophical question.
It's a bad investment is what it is.
Right,
right.
That's a very deep philosophical question. I mean, now, if he was working for Tony Soprano, what kind of cut could he give Tony out of that? Would Tony have to give him a couple of bucks?
If he was working for Tony, he got cut.
Yeah, right.
Oh, that was just stupid.
So, if we will...
Well, that's the problem. That was like a first-time robbery because you get all scared, so you don't like think everything through.
Yeah, but or you don't pay attention to the amount.
Yeah, but don't you think if you're going to go as far as robbing, you want to go big? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
Well, some people aim small, you know?
You know, like Ocean's 11 kind of big.
Well, actually, it's funny. When I was a kid, one of my aunt's neighbors in Florida was Murph the Surf, who stole the Star of India diamond.
Wow.
It was actually supposedly, this is what I was told, I was like a kid, so I believe anything, but seemed like an odd story to make up. There was pictures of him holding me, so I actually dealt with a criminal mastermind before I met Tim.
Wow.
Well, I'm wondering with this guy with the 20.
See, but he's smart because he went for the big diamond.
He did.
Go hard.
Except
for
it's hard to sell that, so how do you make your money unless you already have a buyer?
You have to have a buyer.
Well, I think a guy who figures out how to... See, those are the guys the police sit down, buy you a drink. How'd you pull this off? Unlike this guy where they just, you know, hit him with a water gun, toss him in a cell.
So if it can't really... I was just wondering, like, legally, because it wouldn't be armed robbery because he didn't really rob.
He took money. It just wasn't...
He took money.
Well, he left
that's
his
true.
Money.
And he did... And
this
he
wasn't the same money. So if we were to get this guy a new job, I mean, what's that?
So what do you learn from this? You learn that you bring in a 10 and just buy a stick of gum. That way, you know, what kind of rationale? That way, you're sure to gain some money because it's got to have at least more than $10 in the cash register, right?
It had 15 bucks. Yeah, well.
$15.
Right. So you bring a 10 or a 5.
Well,
that way you can make some money.
The next hood is a little better planned out than this guy. Maybe he heard about the story and he learned from his mistakes. This guy is in Windsor, Ontario, I believe, Canada. They're a little sharper over there, maybe.
Okay.
A.
So he wants to also rob a convenience store.
That's my Canadian impression. A.
But he does not want to end up making the same mistake this guy made.
Okay.
So you know what he does? He calls ahead to find out how much money they have in the register.
Oh, my God. Really?
Really?
You can't make that shit up.
No.
That's just pure mental retardation.
This is a true story.
So... So he calls them to see if they've had a busy day and how much they've got in there.
Yeah, hey, hi. So how much money you usually hold in the register? Like,
yeah.
What do you say?
Or do you make up something?
I'll see you in about 15 minutes.
You know, I'm a bank company and I come by and pick up your money. How much money do you have in your register?
The most amazing part. The most amazing part of this story is that this guy, once they arrested him, they found he was a suspect in two other similar robberies. Now, how
can
a guy this dumb have not been caught so far?
Right.
Yeah. So then people told him how much money is in the cash register? So he must have had a good story.
Well, he got arrested this time because this guy alerted the police and they were waiting for him.
Right.
I want to know how he got away from
the other
two robberies.
I mean, even logistically, you can watch television and see that shit won't work. Do you know what I mean? Like, everybody watches Bong Bong.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you know how...
You know where that sound is from, by the way?
What's that?
That Bong Bong sound in Law & Order?
No.
No, the sound of priests stamping their feet. It's actually a trivia question.
Really?
Really. They recorded them and they, like, doctored it up. For you at home, don't think the show is an educational.
Bong Bong.
It's not all the other nonsense you're going to hear for the next 45 minutes or whatever. Okay. So, should I assume that this was not a good move on this guy's part?
No, I think he's a freaking idiot. Yeah.
Well, that's kind of why he's on the show.
I wish I could be the judge during these type of incidents and be like, get your dumb ass out of this country.
You know, I think
get out of here.
I think we've got a reality show here. Law, like one of these judge shows, but usually on the judge shows, no one gets punished.
Yeah,
Lola could be involved.
She could dish out the punishment.
I'm producing my new show. We're going to bring people on who are open to...
Judge and floggers.
Right.
Crime and punishment.
Crime and punishment! Yes! Absolutely. That'll be the name of our show.
See, I'm innovating, I'm creating.
You know, in night court, they have, like, the bailiff. You could be him. He's really funny.
Yeah. Bull.
Yeah, the bull.
I want to produce this show. I got ideas. I want to be the director of that. I want to be backstage during the interrogation.
Yeah, this is going to be fun.
So absolutely. She can interrogate them. I'll hear the case.
I bring the drinks.
I'm just the punishment.
And then she decides what they get. Yeah. Okay,
and I guess in between there'll be a halftime. You can do like and some show tunes.
She could torture them physically, and I could torture them with sarcasm.
There.
Yes. And the memes that you send everybody.
Right. Okay. Now we're moving on further. This is
we're going in deep.
I think this is a good story. Keep your sexual preferences out of this. There are two young boys involved in this next story.
Oh.
Well, 16 and 18, as I recall. So these
As he recalls. Well, sorry.
I didn't look at my notes. Anyway, these guys, we're now in California, I believe. And they are running from the police. We've all seen this on Law and Order where Lenny Briscoe runs out of breath and sits against the side of a building while his partner chases him down.
Right.
Right. So they're running from the police, and these guys are young and in shape. Mm-hmm. So they come to a fence. They scale the fence.
Okay.
Seemingly having escaped.
Okay.
The only problem is the fence they climbed surrounds the perimeter of San Quentin.
That's funny. That's hysterical.
These two kids just broke into San Quentin.
They just broke into jail.
Just broke into prison.
That's hysterical.
Now, I have seen a lot of prison escape movies. You know, The Great Escape.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Shawshank Redemption. You know, Papillon. I never saw anybody break into maximum security prison before.
Wow. Right. And the fact that they did it so effortlessly is what's keeping from people inside getting out.
Isn't there razor wool?
They just pointed out a flaw in the security. The guys inside might be all annoyed with them, actually. I was planning on getting out that way.
Yeah, right?
Did they pass anybody?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, would have worked. We got in just real fine.
Is it usually razor wire? But unless it's like the outer fence or something like that, maybe it's just a fence and not like razor wire on top of the fence.
Yeah.
They climbed over the fence. This is a real news story.
But how do you not know San Quentin is there?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's just stupid. Yeah.
The same way as you're dumb enough to break into San Quentin, is how you're dumb enough to not know it's there.
Yes, you're right. I'll give it to you.
They must not be from around there. As they say down south, you must not be from around here.
Okay, well, so that was good stuff. Now we're going to get kind of into your territory.
Okay.
Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun.
We gotta
Is Lenny going to come? I want to meet Lenny.
We have to work a female prisoner into it. We have a couple of criminals who are ladies in the show tonight, but this one.
Okay.
She wasn't so much dumb as they just liked the story, but she's a little dumb. She is a call girl, whatever we want to call it. What is politically correct?
It depends on what she
When you're advertising on Craigslist, what do we call you?
Call girl's good for now, until I know what she is.
A call girl is good, is good for me for now,
but
eventually I want to find true love. Yeah.
She could be, you know, a lizard. She could be, you know, whatever.
Okay. Well,
I need to know the details.
She's advertising for clients, and she advertises that for sex with her, you need to bring $60
and
nachos.
Right, she's
a nachos. So she's a hooker with a writer. That's what you're saying, like
with a writer, yeah.
She's
with
a writer. Hungry
and
hooker.
Evian.
She's
Wanta.
A hungry, hungry.
And I need Evian Wanta.
I know.
Now, in your past experiences, did you ever ask clients to bring snacks?
No.
See that.
But
would be
she's
me.
A $60 girl, so.
So if you're paying $200, you could buy your own dinner.
Yes.
All right. Has anybody mixed sex and food? Was that a common thing? Because it doesn't really work for me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not eating anything off anyone.
Whipped
just
cream is the,
so the general public
is
knows.
The usual.
Well,
I'm not going to get as many phone calls
feeders,
after this.
Yeah. Who enjoy feeding.
You know? What's the weirdest thing anybody ever...
Do
they more often want to eat off of you, or have you eat stuff off of them, or what? How does that work?
Gosh, it usually goes back and forth. First you do your tits, and then you do his penis, you know? Mm-hmm.
Oh. Kind of a common way.
That's the way it works with me.
It goes back and forth, and you just, you know. It's usually whipped cream.
Or honey. Honey.
Whipped cream's more easy to clean up than honey.
Yeah.
You need a full shower to clean honey off of you.
Not the way I slurp it up.
No, that's too much honey there.
You might have some other stuff to clean up after a while. Speaking of the icing on the cake.
That's easy to clean up.
So, okay. What is the deal with
that visually? So she wanted $60 in nachos? That's kind of funny. Yeah. That's really funny. Right. I think maybe she was might just being funny.
There
maybe.
Was something else interesting here. What is she? Oh.
I would guess.
Do you know where this happened? Huh. This is true. Mm-hmm. It happened in Ohio, but it happened in Beaver Township. This is actually true. A true story. And what else? She got busted for something else. Wait a minute. She was also charged with solicitation and possession of criminal tools. I don't even want to know what she was going to use those for.
Criminal tools?
I wonder
criminal
if it had to tools? Do with the nachos.
What the hell are criminal tools?
Like, yeah, what constitutes a criminal tool?
I did not know
tool?
Criminal tools existed. I know weapons exist.
I mean, I know a couple criminal tools tool? In Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Live in Brooklyn.
What are their names?
Anything.
I know. Tony, and Tony.
You can declare anything
I know those guys from my
tool.
Building.
I mean, just look at any of those karate movies, you know, where the Jackie Chan, where he just takes anything and shoots. Like a pen or something? Yeah. It could be a criminal tool.
Well.
That doesn't make sense.
We're now going to court.
Okay.
That's my...
Dumb.
Crime and punishment. Bum, bum.
Now, this is a really good one, okay? This guy is arrested for gun possession.
Okay.
Because the cop thinks he sees a bulge in his jacket where he wasn't just happy to see him. But he thinks that... He had probable cause because of the bulge in his jacket. Takes him in front of the judge, and the guy's saying, hey, look, he's full of crap. There was no probable cause to search me. And he happened to be wearing the same jacket. So he tells the judge, check my jacket. Judge is checking it, and bag of cocaine falls out.
How big was this cocaine?
Well, I'm not saying that that's what the bulge was.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I was going to say, that's a lot
of searching jacket. The jacket that he gave him permission to search, the judge himself.
Yeah.
They say it took 5 minutes for the judge to stop laughing, and then he
I would imagine, yeah.
Yeah.
That could happen. I've lost 100 in a coat pocket before.
Anything weird of a thing?
100 grams of cocaine?
No. $100.
No, but I mean, I used to, coke. I would forget that it's in a jacket pocket or weed or something.
Periodically,
yeah,
I just go through all my jacket pockets just to see if I can find cash. Like, whoa.
But it does feel like Christmas, though, right?
It does. Right?
Yeah. When you pull, you're like, $5 extra.
By the way, I don't do drugs anymore.
I remember Lawrence Taylor, who played for the Giants, who had been known to do a little coke in his time.
Who's that?
He's going through Lawrence Taylor. He's going through his locker at Giant Stadium, and he found $10,000 that he forgot about.
What?
Oh,
yeah.
God.
Well, it must be nice to have that kind of disposable income that you don't notice it missing.
Right. When you get to, you know,
that would be like, you know, 20 or 100 or something.
When you're kind of rich.
Yeah.
Or you always accept cash.
Right.
So if we did have a gang, what do you think Tim would do? He has kind of a bad boy energy.
Yeah. I think Tim would be the one to bring in the new recruits.
Oh.
The new recruits of what were we talking now?
We're going to hang around the schoolyard to
not schoolyard.
Outside the local high school.
College, maybe.
College.
Yeah, the college campus, yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
I'll bring in the new recruits.
The new recruits.
Right. Don't defend yourself. You, in particular.
Okay.
There's no excuse for you. No, but you've heard...
I'm usually submissive anyway, so...
Oh.
Submissive is
doesn't seem
work.
Like much of a challenge.
Yeah, you don't have to think.
Submissive is less work. I enjoy being submissive. You just lie there or whatever.
I like
being
submissive.
Being dominant
women.
Is a lot of work.
It is.
I like
it's exhausting being a dominant.
It is exhausting.
Oh my God, it's so much
you
work.
You have to pay attention.
Yes.
You know what I mean? You got to make sure you don't hurt somebody.
You're
you don't
want
to this time.
You got to make sure you don't hurt them. Yeah.
I like the attitude you girls are showing here. I think there's some possible progress. Okay,
so easy.
Anyway, they always say that someone who defends himself as a fool is a client.
That kind of
has
defend. I thought you meant defend. Like,
yeah. Oh, my husband tried to do that to me.
Defend you in court?
Yes, what a fool. Yes.
So you are a felon. You're wanted. What
oh, no. This is just regular, like, traffic court shit. So he came up, he was like, you should let me be the lawyer. I was like, you're a comedian. Are you kidding me? And he's like, no, I watch Bong Bong. You know what I mean? And I was like, get the hell away from me. So I just had to pay my fine and get out before I got embarrassed and dishonored my family. You know what I mean?
So you didn't allow him to defend you?
Absolutely not.
Oh.
Absolutely not.
I don't know. So, it can be fun. You don't have nothing to lose. Like, I've gone to trash court a couple of times.
Trash court?
Oh, yeah. You know, you get a ticket, like a $100 ticket, if there's like leaves in front of your building or something. And so I'm like, that was not our problem. You know, there was, and I brought in like weather reports. It was like 90 mile an hour wind and shit, you know, and
but we're at the end of the corridor.
Yeah. And like, I pleaded my case, and he's like, okay, get out of here.
Really?
Yeah. You have nothing to lose. Yeah. Yeah. It depends. Like, if you bring in a weather report where it was like windy, and it was like still 90 degree winds when the damn sanitation bitch like wrote the tickets.
I didn't know there was a trash court.
Oh yeah. If you get a trash ticket, you know, for like not recycling correctly or any kind of
criminal.
Yeah, any kind of garbage that's left out in front, they give you a $100 ticket.
That could be could be a good reality show that's been on right after Hoarders.
Trash court. That would be funny.
Like, it's not my McDonald's bag.
That'll be another show.
I even dug through garbage bags.
We got a whole
some people would leave like their garbage bag in front, and we'd get in trouble because it's not like closed up and everything. I'd bring in the garbage with the letter from the people next door. I'd be like, this is their garbage. They put it in front of us.
Oh.
You know, I once got
it's
a
fun.
Speaking of traffic tickets, I once got a ticket. Park in the city, looked at the sign, looked fine, go, come back, I got a ticket. I looked at the sign, it was no parking 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
Okay.
And no standing 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. Yeah, why don't you say no parking anytime?
Yeah, that's confusing.
So I actually sent in a letter and pleaded insanity, not mind the cities. And they dismissed it.
They did.
Well, it was a lot more to the letter. I wrote a funny letter. See, I was as annoying as your husband would have been.
Yeah.
You could have gotten
off. Sometimes when you're funny or whatever, yeah, the judges, you know, they got boring jobs. It's the same shit over and over again.
They want to hear
you bring them some entertainment, they're like, okay, yeah, sure.
Okay. All right. This guy decides to defend himself. We're in Oklahoma now.
Okay.
There's a lot of stuff going on in the Midwest, apparently.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, this guy decides to defend himself in court. He robbed, of all things, a convenience store. What's with the convenience stores?
You know, they're convenient.
They're
hello. Right there on the side of the road. Like, the access.
We have an answer, folks. Ding, ding. Okay, well, this guy
decided. Was there more than $15 in the cash register?
We'll get to that.
Oh, Lord.
All right. This guy robs a convenience store, gets caught, and he decides to be his own attorney.
Oh, boy.
Mm-hmm. Now,
money.
The prosecutor actually said he was doing a good job. Mm-hmm. Until he happens to be interrogating the clerk who was there when he robbed it. And she says he was the guy. And he gets up and says, I should have blown your damn head off.
Oh, man. Yeah, there's certain things you can't say. Yeah.
If it was you. If it was me.
Wow. That'd be a little incriminating, yes.
So should we assume this guy should not have been...
So then he is the fool for a client.
Right. Yes.
He's the epitome of that story, yeah.
Actually, his father should have just masturbated that night.
Oh, no!
Then he would have gotten off.
We're so corny, Beth. Why are we laughing?
We're talking about sex and we just got the clap, but that's another story.
As the lawyer, he could have objected and said, I object, Your Honor. My client is surely showing insanity.
Yes, like, he could have gotten off for an insanity plea.
A stiff fine for sure.
And like did a whole schizophrenic thing going back and forth between, and then he proved
it. Getting into an argument, the client and the lawyer and the...
People got it good. Like they
totally
got it
improv. It just go off. Yeah. Colbert could have gotten off.
Yes.
All right. We're not leaving court yet. This guy's good. I like this guy.
Okay.
All right. Grand Theft Auto. Steals a car, gets caught, as most dumb criminals do. Part of the job description. Uh-huh. And he's got to go to court to testify. And he's conscientious. He shows up. Mm-hmm. The only problem is he drove to court in a stolen car.
Yeah.
In the stolen car?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. I think he probably had to give that one back.
I got the evidence to prove it, Your Honor.
He then parked in front of the courthouse.
Oh, my goodness.
In a car full of Yorkies that are yapping up a storm.
What the hell? What kind of criminal this with a brood of
No, balls. This dude is drunk and high on meth. Yeah. Okay, come on.
I hope not, because he's a barber. And
for Yorkies?
No. He's a barber in San Francisco, and from what I understand, his accomplices complained because they didn't get their cut.
Wow.
No, but this is true. And he gets busted for driving to court in a stolen car and convicted for the previous theft of the other vehicle.
Oh, he's just 20 shades of crazy then. He deserves it.
Wait, did he steal the Yorkies? Or did the
no,
Yorkies just
those are
the
his
car?
Dogs. Those are his dogs.
So he stole the car, put 20 Yorkies in it, and then drove.
Who has 20 freaking Yorkies?
Not 20 Yorkies? You're multiplying this, man.
Wait, how many Yorkies?
Oh, I thought you said 20.
Yorkies. No.
Oh, a bunch of Yorkies.
20.
Yeah,
that's
I thought
like
a you petting said
20.
Zoo. Yeah, right.
I thought that's what
so
you said.
Yeah,
I
thought
I would have broken into that car just to play with the dogs.
I have one.
Do
and
you?
I'm like, yeah.
I love Yorkies. So they're fun.
Awesome. I love my dog.
Yorkies are cute. I like Chihuahuas.
Yeah, I like
love
Chihuahuas
those
too, but
crazy ass personalities.
I like Chihuahuas, except they look like angry little old men.
I know, they're so fun. They're just funny.
My Chihuahua is vicious.
You have a Chihuahua too?
Yes. Yeah. I have a Yorkie.
You have a petting
that's
zoo.
That's what I like about Chihuahuas.
Have you like monkeys like or anything?
No, I have a lizard.
A lizard?
I have a bearded dragon.
Ooh, I like lizards too. Yeah. Lizards are great. I like lizards. They got.
I should be hanging
attitude.
Out at Lola's house. Petting her dragon, so to
speak. Wow, wow.
All right.
Bong, bong.
All right. We're now heading to North Dakota.
Oh, okay. I'm so sorry.
Have you been to North Dakota?
You betcha. No.
I did a show in Bismarck, North Dakota that took forever to get there. There is nothing there except like about four houses, and that's the capital
of
the state.
Is it like 4 hours of nothing or 6 hours of nothing driving?
A band I was in, yeah.
It
was what?
Is it like 4 hours of nothing driving or 6 hours
yes,
of nothing
yes,
driving?
Yes, absolutely.
Like
of nothing.
Of nothing, yeah.
Nothing,
yeah.
Nothing, nothing. No houses,
that's like
no,
parts
nothing.
Of Texas. There's like 4 hours of just
I might have
driving.
A panic attack if something like that happens.
Mm-hmm.
Did the show go well? Do you have much of an audience? There were four houses. I mean, that was like three people. Did they fly them in or what?
I don't know. I don't even remember. I was so bummed with that
hey,
one.
Hey, people in Bismarck need entertainment.
But they were
also.
Nice. Yeah, it was yeah. It was nice. They were nice.
Wait, so what did
and
this
probably
city
more
do?
Grateful so, because not too many people make it out there.
Right.
So
there are a lot of Native Americans in North Dakota. So
I would
at the
imagine.
Show, at the show, did they probably. Take reservations?
Oh, Andy. That one
Andy.
Hurt.
I'll drink to that. Okay. Anyway. So we have not much more reaction to this Bushmilk in North Dakota. Okay.
Okay. Wait.
No,
well,
in North
what
Dakota,
happened?
What happened?
Oh, right. Well, that's probably why.
Yeah. Off about North Dakota.
Yeah, we're waiting for after driving for hours. I want to hear what he did.
He robbed a bank.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is a bank. Maybe
doesn't make
money,
him a bad person.
Store.
Okay.
All right. And he goes in there with his ransom note, hands it to the clerk, who is scared, gives him the money, he leaves. Call the police, they're trying to track him down. They examine the note. The only problem is, it was his bank and he wrote it on the back of his deposit slip.
Oh my God, seriously?
Wow.
They found him on his porch.
Yeah. Counting yeah. money.
Counting money, right? What an idiot.
Now, in my case, it might, the problem with this would have been writing out the deposit slip in any way that someone could, or the ransom note in any
yeah.
way anyone could read.
Exactly. Yeah.
How is your handwriting, Tim? Maybe that's what we can
no,
use you
it's,
for.
But you know,
no, no.
On the back of the deposit slip, it's like carbon, kind of. Do you know what I mean? So that's got to...
Not always. The ones I have in my bank now, it's just... Regular
yeah, the new
bank.
One, so that would have been
older. Yeah,
one.
See,
guess that shows my age.
I had to do a handwritten letter about a month ago, and after I wrote it out, I looked at it, and I was like, oh my God, my handwriting is horrible, because I never write anymore. I always type.
Mm-hmm. Well, my handwriting was horrible. That's why it's better now, because I'm not actually writing. My handwriting is very good on the computer.
Yes.
Remember the Woody Allen movie when I know it was like Play It Against Sam or Take the Money and Run or something. He's robbing a bank and he hands them the note. Nobody could read it. And they're all getting together and trying to figure out what
it
says.
A sketch, yeah.
That's a good
yeah,
one, yeah.
Yeah. Nobody can read it. What, sir? Do you want to make a deposit?
Well,
yeah.
What is this word? What is Woody doing these days?
I'm sure there's many like illiterate criminals as well. Can you imagine? Mm. There should be like a hall of fame of like dumb ransom notes.
That might be another show.
Yeah,
the museum of dumb ransom notes.
Yeah.
Can you imagine being a collector? People collect everything. Collecting dumb ransom notes. Or ransom notes in general.
Yeah,
I went to an interesting house in Florida where they had like a bunch of like criminal memorabilia. And there's also a crime museum in New York. I had like the guy from that on my old radio show.
Oh, okay.
Museum of Crime or so. Mm-hmm. Their mafia museum, something like that.
So is it mostly mafia, or is it divided into different sections like murder, robbery, rape?
I don't recall. I saw the car that Bonnie and Clyde were shot in, supposedly, unless they faked it.
All right, so probably just sensationalized.
But that was the thing in Florida.
Right, like
that was actually a pretty cool thing to say.
Yeah, I don't know if they have like murder land and rape land.
Okay. You'll have
come
the black
on, guys, let's go to rape land. Let's go.
This isn't rape land. Well, it's the same as visiting the Holocaust Museum.
Rape land, that's either good or bad publicity, depending on who you're
raping?
Dealing with.
Oh.
Well, either way, right. Yeah, I was thinking from the perspective of the victim. You're thinking of the perspective of the rapist, and I appreciate
that. Of the dominant. Yeah.
She's a fun date.
I am.
I still think I would enjoy having you interrogate my...
I'm sure you would.
I'm going to become a kidnapper, so she can get information out of them. And you'll make snacks.
You'll make snacks.
I'll make the nachos.
Great, bring nachos. That'll be your job.
And I'm wondering, I was thinking, okay, from where? Like, from Taco Bell? Or does she want from a Mexican restaurant? Like, what quality of nachos does she want?
Oh, honey, if she's advertising,
she seems flexible.
She probably wants, like, the 7-Eleven one with the cheese that comes out the thing.
Yeah.
I would have written to her and said, okay, which quality of nachos do you want? Because if I'm getting the good ones, I'm only bringing $55.
Tortilla chips and cheese whiz. And
there we go. Like, yeah. That would probably do.
Yeah, with $60, yeah. Mm-hmm.
$60.
That is
cheap. Who does
ass,
anything
man.
For $60?
That's cheap ass.
Like $60.
Yeah.
Bands play in New York for like $40 for like 9 guys.
What? Really?
Bands. Oh, yeah. Are you kidding me? Get a rock band playing in a village somewhere?
Oh, okay.
Well, you're lucky if you get a drink.
Yeah. Hopefully you'll be able to put on your you know, your website and everything like that. Ooh, I performed at, you know, back in the day, CBGBs.
Right. Yeah, right.
You know.
Right.
So, and that looks good in Bismarck, North Dakota. Well, that you,
I'll tell you,
went
I played
to some bar
CBGBs.
In New York.
Don't you know?
Don't you know?
I played at CBGBs
and performed
many times.
In the East Village,
like the worst
don't you
money.
Know?
CBGBs was like the worst money. Not only did you make no money, but I was very conscientious. I brought like an extra bass drum skin in case I broke my skin. Had it in the box. When I went to leave, someone had taken my bass drum skin out and put a torn one in its place.
Oh, man.
I probably lost
it. It was pretty rough in the East Village,
thanks.
I love the village.
Worst vacation plans ever.
Whoa, that could be a huge...
That runs a spectrum.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus, those, right. That can make
starting with the Titanic.
Yeah, that wasn't a good vacation at all.
It's a good joke, man. You iced it.
That one sucked.
Big time.
All right. This guy, we're now back in a bank, except this is an employee.
Okay.
Well, you
he embezzles $200,000 in bank fraud.
Wow, that's a lot.
Now, you might want to kind of, so it's more than the $60. He could have probably come
Wait,
to her a
Wall
bunch
Street
of times.
Wall Streeters do like billions of dollars in bank fraud.
Yeah.
Like, what's $200,000?
Yeah,
all right, well, this guy takes $200,000, right?
That's like $20.
Is it little, in little
store.
Increments or all at one shot?
I just know. I think
15,
it was a total.
15 from the convenience store.
Now,
it's cheap.
You'd think he might want to lay low. Instead, he goes on vacation.
Okay.
All right. Oh, I forgot to give you this whole section of the show. This is our Facebook segment of the show.
Okay.
Because we're all friends on Facebook. Tim doesn't even talk to me in real life usually.
Oh, yeah.
But it's all right. So this guy steals the $200,000 from the bank, goes on vacation, brags about it on Facebook. The vacation, not the stealing the $200,000.
Okay.
So this
what
guy.
What is it with people bragging on Facebook about stuff?
Right, exactly. So this guy brags.
Do they think that they have like a privacy group and nobody can talk to them besides
people
or
seem
see
to have
them?
This false sense of reality that not everybody sees what you're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
People
I mean, it takes a lot of time for all the cops to go through every single Facebook account.
But what gets me is when you see the guys that have like
all the money, and they're like,
yeah, right.
Look at all the money, and they're like, they show a gun in their pocket, yeah, right. And their beer, and they're like, yeah,
like, that should yeah, be you like should badass get criminal face.
Yeah, right.
Our show has waitress service. I love this. Yeah, can we get the check?
I'll take some nachos.
And 60 bucks. So you got to my 60 bucks?
60 bucks.
All right. Well, this isn't the whole story, though. So this guy steals the 200 grand, goes on vacation.
Okay.
Brags about it on Facebook, and then accepts a friend request from a Department of Justice agent.
Oh, my God.
Wow. He's desperate for followers.
Yeah. And he wants followers. Yeah. That's insane.
Because I'm guessing that he posted pictures of his extravagant vacation.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah. You know, talked about it and stuff.
Wow, people are really
stupid.
Well,
because you can't go on vacation unless you take pictures and brag about it on Facebook.
That's true.
Because okay. That's the fun of going on vacation.
Yeah, that's the only reason, especially an extravagant vacation.
Why are you looking at me?
You're the one that's always going to Mexico.
Yeah, that's work-related.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Nice work if you can get it.
We're now heading to Colorado.
Okay.
Yeah.
For someone, for someone who has been, man, so this is the place you would go.
Yeah, I'm going. I'm actually going to be in Denver, the end of March, the beginning of February.
This work, ooh. Play, work,
wait,
play.
Wait,
she's
work.
I'm work. Appearing for the.
You mean the end of February, beginning of March?
Oh no, March, April. Sorry, my bad.
Oh, okay.
My bad. So yeah, no, it's the Exotica convention in Denver.
Oh,
cool.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It'd be nice to take a trip.
I might have to winter this. I might have to look into this.
You should come. We just leave there. This is going to be fantastic. I don't know if I'll get any work done, but I will physically be in the area.
Okay.
There we go.
So, I could be in your area.
Of my dragon? Is that what you're asking?
Well, where is this?
Oh, no, we're going to Denver. We'll be in Denver. March 31st through April 2nd.
Is it colder there than here? That time of year? What is it like?
Well,
assume.
It's a mile high city, so I'm
I
guessing
know. You can join the Mile High Club.
Yeah.
With that, you could be a virgin and be in the Mile High Club in Denver.
Yeah, that's I guess true. You can. I guess you can.
Twice.
There's hope for you.
Three times.
I lost my virginity three times.
I did.
Call
I
me.
Did.
$2.99 a minute.
I know, $2.99
call as often as you like.
Bring nachos.
Bring nachos.
All right.
I just love those colors.
Oh, okay.
Four if you're really small.
So we're now in Colorado, okay?
Yes.
For a guy labeled Facebook's dumbest member. So this was a lot.
That has to be him. That's the guy you were just talking about, right?
That'd make a great group.
I haven't gotten into this guy yet.
Oh, you haven't? I thought that was
no, this guy tops the other guy.
Oh, my God.
All right. This guy breaks into a woman's house. Mm-hmm. She wakes up with him standing over her in the bed.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's scary.
That
biggest
is.
Nightmare ever.
She freaks out, screams. Mm-hmm. He gets scared. He grabs a cell phone and runs.
Her cell phone?
Yeah.
Fucking dummy.
Well, that's not the dumb part. Okay. I mean, it's a dumb part.
Yeah, but you could track a cell phone.
But mm-hmm. He checks out, must have checked out the pictures in her cell phone. He must have liked what he's seen because he sent her a friend request.
Can we be friends?
Hi, remember me?
And then on the phone that he's got, bleep, you've got a friend request.
I'm the guy who did the B&E and was standing right on top of you when you woke up. Yeah, freaking idiot.
Can we go out? I have my own phone now.
I know. Why don't you call me on your line?
You know the number.
Call me anytime. You know the number.
For $2.99 a minute. Oh, wow. That amazes me.
I don't know. I just think that's the ego of some men, right?
Yeah.
Some men are so arrogant that they think, oh, she saw me for half a second and screamed. She must love me.
She saw me in the dark hovering over her bed.
She wants to have my baby.
I sent her a really charming request. You know,
yeah.
Or a dick pic.
Yeah.
She's gonna love it.
She's gonna love this.
Everyone loves a dick pic.
Don't send dick pics. Don't do that.
Well, you can to me.
Well, to Tim, but not the rest of us.
Well, actually, I had three horror film actresses on my Scream Queen show.
Okay.
And one of them, we spent a lot of time talking about dick pics.
Mm-hmm.
Well, okay. She apparently, one of them, Genevieve Rossi, gets a lot of them. Mm. And yeah, we were discussing, who does that? Well, Anthony Weiner does that, actually.
Yes.
People running our country do that.
Yes, right.
He just got out of his little rehab thing.
There's a rehab for that?
He was in like
for sexting.
Sex?
Yeah, and sexting.
What could be sadder than being sexting?
Because I want him to come back because I love how fucking fierce he is. And, like, he was the only one that ever screamed and yelled and was, like, obnoxious towards the Republicans and shit. Everyone
and
else is always so nice.
Right in his crotch.
Yeah, but yeah. Everyone else is always so nice. They're like, I disagree. I don't think that the Klan is, you know.
Yeah.
You know? And he's like, fuck the Klan.
So you feel it's great to be with a leader.
Yeah, I hope he's cured and I want him to come back. Because he's the only one that, like, at least has any kind of balls and a dick.
And we've seen him.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And he'll show you.
Quite frankly, I would fuck Anthony Weiner. He's got, like,
really?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I would, too.
The testosterone that he's
yeah,
got.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't think his penis is that big.
I don't care.
No, no, no. He's one of those fuckers that just fuck.
Yeah, he's a machine.
But I'd have to be in a mood for it, though, and well lubricated. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, he's one of those
here.
That's just like... Yeah, him and Spitzer.
Is there any particular brand you recommend when dealing with a guy like Anthony Weiner?
Lubricant?
Uberlube.
That stuff that doesn't get sticky. Oh. I forget which one it is, but one of them gets sticky. Like the scent, like the
K-Y.
Flavored ones and stuff get sticky.
Silicone is a little bit sticky. The water-based ones are not.
Yeah, the water-based ones. The other ones get sticky way too fast. Yeah.
So this show remains educational.
Yeah.
And we're back to sex.
Yeah, yeah. I definitely would have a good time with both of them. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, Giuliani, no, I'd run away from the hotel room.
Ooh.
Putin, I would not go anywhere alone with Putin. Hell no. He's scary. Cheney's scary. But Spitzer and Weiner, yeah.
So it's interesting how the names of all these guys.
Spitzer and Weiner.
Yeah, right.
The names of all these guys are. Weiner. The names of all these guys all seem very sexual. Weiner,
Putin.
Spitzer.
Spitzer.
Yeah, Spitzer's very nasty, like.
Yeah.
Can you imagine, like, if you were the daughter?
I got your lube right here.
And like, so your last name would be like Marion Spitzer Weiner.
And what?
Weiner Spitzer.
And what if he named her Swallow?
Swallow Weiner Spitzer.
We're in pretty deep now.
That would be a great porno name. Shit,
look at the things
they
come up
name.
With.
She's so
I'm a
creative.
PR genius.
Swallow Wiener Spitzer. That's my name.
Swallow Spitzer.
Okay.
Swallow Spitzer.
We are now going to Austin, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
We're out of court. Eugene Butch Flennow.
What?
Okay.
This is the fellow's name.
Eugene Butch
Flennow.
Flennow
Jr.
Okay. Junior. He's a junior.
So he has a lot to live up to. I don't have any information on dad.
Okay.
All right.
Well, in this show, that's a good thing for the dad.
He's robbing some
convenience store.
Was it a convenience store?
Or bank.
Pizza restaurant.
Never a brothel.
Oh, okay.
Pizza restaurant. Right?
These criminals are so stupid. You're looking for something bigger.
Then they wouldn't be dumb criminals.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
So I had some dumbass when I was doing in-call try to rob me at 10 a.m. in the morning. I told him. He got out his stupid little puny knife, and I looked at it, and I said, dude, it's 10 a.m. in the morning. You don't rob an in-call place unless it's at least 8 or 9 o'clock at night. Then you get the whole day.
You're schooling
him. I'm
the
new first
plan.
One on duty.
She's now the leader
money.
Of his gang.
I was like, I've got no money, you idiot.
Let me suck some dick first, and then you'll get paid.
But if you got $60 and some nachos.
We can party, baby.
I was like, seriously. You're so stupid.
That'll give you something to do till 10 o'clock tonight when I finally made some bucks.
Wow.
Yeah, I was like, this must be your first time.
Come here, honey. Let me show you how.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm standing in the kitchen because it's an in-call, right? So it's an apartment. And I got my hand on the drawer full of knives.
Yeah.
And my butcher knives in my drawer are fucking bigger than your stupid little pocket knife.
So you would take in-calls to your actual apartment?
No, not my apartment. It's an in-call place.
Oh,
yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah. But no, stupid criminal. You don't rob a brothel at 10 o'clock in the morning.
I don't. I don't, but I don't get up till noon, so.
Exactly. That's my point.
I have everything planned out.
All right, so what did he rob?
He robs a pizza restaurant.
Pizza place.
He goes there on his motorcycle. And he wears his motorcycle helmet when he goes in to disguise his face.
Well, that's
which
brilliant.
Is pretty good.
Unless he's got his name on it.
Yeah.
Ding ding.
And then he's driving down.
We have
game.
A winner.
And you have like peace signs thrown up, and there's like if you CCTV find this, everywhere.
If you find this helmet, call Tony at this number.
Eugene Butch Flanow.
Stupid criminal things.
You're good at this. She's really good at this.
I've met a couple stupid criminals. They're so stupid.
It's great seeing how the criminal mind works.
What gets me is that they always think that I'm going to be stupid. Yeah. Dude, I'm sitting here watching you.
I can just see Tara. You freaking asshole. It's 8 o'clock in the morning.
You don't do it now. Wait till 10 at night because then you go.
I want them to get all my money.
Do their thing and then come in and rob the day shift girl. Yeah. And then wait until afterwards and rob the nighttime girl like around 2, 3, 4 in the morning.
Yeah. Duh.
All right.
Jesus.
I'm skipping ahead because there's a story I really like. Okay. Stop me if you heard this one. A man walks into a bar with a zebra and a parrot.
Wait, that's the beginning of it.
A zebra and a parrot?
A zebra and a parrot.
Is this
sure
a joke
not, like,
or a
priest
real?
And a rabbi?
Yes, and yes.
And the parrot had a cigar. Oh. So
now, where was this? Iowa.
Who's
a zebra in Iowa?
Yeah, a zebra and a parrot.
This guy pulls into the parking lot of the Doghouse Lounge.
Okay.
All right. The parking lot of the Doghouse Lounge with a zebra and a parrot in his car.
Okay.
It's got to be in his trailer. The zebra won't fit.
Were there 20 Yorkies?
No.
Okay.
No.
It's got to be in
the zebra
trailer.
Was very territorial.
Okay.
And he claims that the place allowed animals on that date because they weren't serving food. So he tries to get into this place with a zebra and his parrot, but he doesn't make it past the parking lot because he's apparently driving erratically. They check him out.
Because you have a fucking zebra in your car, dude. Who carries a zebra in their car?
I don't personally.
Me either.
So why was he driving erratically?
His blood alcohol
zebra
was
in the car.
Double.
There's a fucking zebra in the car, dude.
Was double the legal limit, and he had a zebra in his car.
Driver.
Double. Watch the speed
bump. I got to check out this guy's name if they got it because.
Wasn't this
Gerald Reeder?
Gerald Reeder.
Because I want to know the name of a guy who drives around Iowa with a zebra.
Okay, yeah.
So he's right. Drunk with a...
Not concerned about the welfare of the zebra, apparently.
That's what I'm wondering. Was he drunk and went to a zoo and just stole the zebra? And
no, these are his pets.
Okay.
What? How do you get a zebra as a pet? I can't even get a freaking hedgehog in New York.
You're in New York. This is Iowa. Iowa.
Ugh. God.
I went to a petting zoo in Tennessee that had a zebra.
Maybe animal control.
The Knoxville Deer Park and Exotic Petting Zoo.
Maybe he had like a petting zoo. Maybe that's what it was.
No, he's just crazy.
He's just a freaking idiot.
Listen, I know there's zebras at the old like Rockefeller Estate or something.
No, I'm
he had a zoo. Or was it Hearst? He had a zoo and he had a flock of zebras. Yeah, and so now there's like wild zebras running around.
No, there's this petting zoo I went to in Tennessee that had a zebra. I got to feed it and pet it. Very exciting.
I can tell.
He pulls into the parking lot. They check his blood alcohol. It's 1.4.
Okay.
And it's 0.8 is the legal limit.
Okay.
So the guy's blasted out of his mind with a zebra and his macaw on his shoulder.
And having a damn good time, I'm sure.
But you know what? It makes me wonder what's going through his head.
Right?
Do you know what I mean?
What led up to that? What
a bottle of Bacardi was going through his head.
A bottle of Bacardi. But it must be like, could you imagine just in your car, like, I'm a fucking zebra, man!
Come on, let's go to the bar!
Put the top down.
I know you got black and white stripes, but there's not a dress code. Let's go. You know what I mean?
Wait a minute.
It's Zebra Day.
It's Sunday, and they're not serving food, so you can come on in. Come on, let's go to the bar. What the hell?
I bet you the McCall was like, you're an asshole. You're an asshole.
Well, there was no information on whether the zebra or the parrot were drunk, but we do understand the McCall was slurring his speech.
That's funny.
Okay.
Like, what are you thinking? Like, when I have my dogs in the car, I'm like, sit down! Sit down! You're going to, if I stop short, you're going to crash right into the windshield. Do you know what I mean? Could you imagine a zebra?
Like,
bouncing
around.
Yeah.
Trying to stick them
sitting
in
there like
cage.
This.
Do zebras even neigh?
I don't know. I don't know.
I'm sure they make some noise. Every animal makes some noise.
I've never heard a zebra noise.
Zebras? They got to say something.
Kind of like
you know who doesn't say
like
anything? Giraffes.
Yeah.
Giraffes don't say anything.
They're quiet.
Huh. Well, that's because their voice box is probably clear down at the, no. you know. Like, it wouldn't.
So they would be
good. It takes a while to travel up.
Yeah.
They would be good to have in the gang.
By the time it reaches, it's just a
high
note.
Yeah, it's
note.
Like,
ah! This is the airlift.
giraffes
we
are
so easily entertained, it's disgusting.
All right. We're now going to Pennsylvania.
Okay. These are all American people. Oh, except for the guy from Windsor. Okay.
Right.
Oh, we have such a brilliant country.
Yeah.
The Amish.
Dumbing down of America.
Yes. Amish.
I love their butter.
Yeah.
I do. I love their freaking butter.
You saw last Tango in Paris.
I love Amish country.
That one went right over her head, but...
I'm not even paying attention to you. Go ahead.
I know.
Last Tango in Paris.
The butter. Oh, the butter.
The butter. I know.
Oh, last time. Oh, that's awesome.
Anyway.
It's disturbing.
Yeah. I know. Yeah. That's what he said. We're not paying attention to him. We're just going to keep doing the show.
Anyway. An Amish teen, 17-year-old kid, runs a stop sign.
In his horse and buggy?
In his horse and buggy?
Like a zebra.
Like, what is he doing? Oops, sorry.
He's chased down by the police. In a very, very low-speed chase.
Okay.
In his horse and buggy.
On foot.
In his horse and buggy.
What is their police department like in Amish country?
Well, actually, do you remember those shows they were having for a while? Amish Mafia and stuff? They had some reality shows about the Amish organized crime.
Really?
And it was always like, you put a dent in my haystack or something. It was always like the dumbest crimes.
Your food is not organic.
Yeah.
You kicked my rooster or something?
Your mother's apple pie was too sour.
But actually, if you want to see something, a great show about Amish criminal who you really can respect. You ever see Banshee?
No.
Great show.
No.
The great show, Banshee, Pennsylvania is what it's named after. I won't give you all the details of the show. It's a great show. And there's a Amish organized crime figure involved.
Okay.
And he's scary.
Really?
But this is, of course, fantasy. You see the Amish reality show. And you see the dented haystack and the limping chicken.
Limp chicken?
The limping chicken.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought you said limp chicken.
So what was this guy charged with? Hold on a minute.
So the Amish guy ran the stop Levy sign
Detweiler.
With his horse and carriage.
He ran the stop sign with his horse and buggy.
And the cops ran him down on foot.
I wonder, do they have like one of those speed guns? You know what I mean?
With an hourglass in it?
Turn the hourglass over on
With an hourglass.
With an hourglass.
Yep, he's doing 5 minutes. He's doing
but you know what?
Minutes.
It's okay because they're never going to see this.
Right. They heard the first line out of my mouth. They turned the computer off, threw it out the window. Okay, well, what he was charged with, what was he charged with? A whole
Galloping
bunch of stuff.
Galloping unnecessary.
He was charged with underage possession of alcohol.
Oh.
This is your kind of Amish guy.
So that's why he ran the stop sign.
Reckless endangerment. Reckless endangerment.
Of an animal.
And overdriving an animal. Failure to stop at a stop sign and failure to yield to an emergency vehicle. Overdriving an animal, what the hell kind of crime is that?
But he was probably, you know, oh, the cops are coming. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up.
Get it up to 3 miles an hour.
Exactly, the okay. cops are after us.
We didn't get to all of our dumb criminals.
Oh, damn.
But we're going to have
Next
to leave.
Time.
You guys have quick contact information for us.
Yes, Tym Moss, T-Y-M-M-O-S-S, on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all of that.
I am Lola Bastinado everywhere. You can find me on my website, lolabastinado.com or comedysexshow.com.
Tara, T-R-A-N-Y. Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, Comedy Sex Show.
Yay.
Yay.
Okay, we're going to be leaving you shortly. We will be back again. Remember, go to our Facebook page, The Andy Troy Show, and like us. Go to our Twitter, not Twitter. What am I trying to say?
YouTube.
Go to YouTube and follow us, The Andy Troy Show. When I turn around, I expect to see you following me.
Real shit.
Okay, we will be back soon with more exciting stuff. But for now, Tym, Lola,
Tara,
me, we're gone.